During 1967, while the ghettos of Jamaica was growing with grief and frustration from the unemployment and low levels of living, the Jamaican music scene was changing from a happy, up-tempo dance music to a more social music that was bringing to the world the voice of the poor man from the ghettos and slums of Jamaica. The music was called reggae, and it was pioneered by Bunny Lee, the man on the organ, Ernest Ranglin, the man on guitar, Lee Scratch Perry, the producer, and Clancy Eccles, the songwriter and vocalist. And the first reggae song was called Feel the Rhythm.
Feel the rhythm, you love the rhythm, dance the rhythm, upset the rhythm, you love the rhythm, you feel the rhythm, you dance the rhythm, upset the rhythm. I don't know, and I don't know, I near got people bad-minded so. I don't know, and I don't know, I near got people bad-minded so. If you try to reach the top, they will want to see.
And in the same year, Clancy Eccles produced a song called Say What You're Saying, a song by Monty Morris, which officially made Clancy the originator of the new craze, reggae. But the word reggae was not officially the name of the new music until Toots and the Maytals put out a song titled Do the Reggae in 1968, which made Toots Ibbert the godfather for the new creation, which was rapidly growing in the streets of Jamaica. Boundaries for reggae was yet to be explored, but an American musician who goes by the name of Johnny Nash in 1968 got a hit single with a reggae song titled Hold Me Tight, a song that broke down barriers and showed the great potential the new music had. Meanwhile in Jamaica, Clancy Eccles and Toots Ibbert, two of the most influential men in music business at the time, were now debating on who was the true originator of the art form, leading to the first Clash song noted in reggae music titled Bugaboo by Clancy Eccles, a song he made to let musicians and fans know he was the originator. But reggae in its true essence is roots music, and a group of young men who was coming from the ska era with their unique style of roots music were about to take the reggae to new heights. This group of young men went by the name Wailing Wailers, with Peter Tosh on guitar, Bonnie Wailer on percussion. The vocalist in this band will later break off when he signed to Island Records, a UK-based record label ran by the man known as Chris Blackwell. The vocalist's name was Bob Marley. Without Peter and Bonnie, he started a new band and labeled themselves Bob Marley and the Wailers. They opened doors and made new audience for reggae music, and Bob Marley will later be known as the king of reggae, and he is also the most famous reggae musician without diluting or moving away from his roots music style of reggae. The stage was set and reggae became the official music of Jamaica, with ska and rocksteady musicians converting to reggae, and new reggae artists were coming out of the woodwork every other day. There was no going back. Reggae is here to stay.